Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.3, Problem 2. This is Section 10.3, Problem number 2. It says, a recent study was conducted to determine if the average age of students enrolled at BCC's New Bedford campus is older or younger than the average age of all BCC students, which is 25.6. A sample of 25 New Bedford students had an average age of X bar equal to 24.8, with a sample standard deviation of S equal to 3.5 years. Is there enough evidence to conclude that the average age of New Bedford students is different than the average age of all BCC students? Use a 10% level of significance. So, this is a hypothesis test. There's a six-step process. In this particular type of test, we have to use the sample standard deviation. We don't happen to know the population standard deviation. It makes a little bit of a difference. Similar process. So the first step, step one, is state the null hypothesis. So the symbol is H with a subscript of 0, mu, the population mean, is, in this case, equal to 25.6. Now, your null hypothesis will contain the condition of equality. It'll either have an equal to, like this problem does, or a greater than or equal to, possibly, or a less than or equal to. So that's the first step, state the null hypothesis. The second step is state the alternate hypothesis. So you'll have mu, a little bit of a space I'll leave, and the same number again. So the alternate hypothesis, capital H subscript of 1, with a colon, same mu, same number, but different symbol. So your possible options for the symbol for the alternate hypothesis are just less than, just greater than, or not equal to. So what are we testing here? It winds up being the not equal to. Because we want to see if they're younger or older, and also later in the problem it just says, see if it's different, and different is underlined. So it's not necessarily younger or older, just different. So that would be not equal to. So that's my step two. I have determined the alternate hypothesis. Mu is not equal to 25.6. So the third step is determine what type of test we have, left tail, right tail, or two tail. To determine the type of test, you want to look at the inequality symbol in the alternate hypothesis and see which direction it's pointing. That'll tell you what type of test it is. In the case of a not equal to, it's a two tail test. So for two-tail, you have a critical region at each end of your graph. That's what we're going to have. That's the two-tail. So the next step, step four, is calculate t. So again, we're doing t because we have to use the sample standard deviation. If we knew the population standard deviation, we would calculate z. Similar process, but a little bit of a difference. So t is X bar minus mu over S divided by square root of n. So we'll go ahead and fill in that formula. T equals X bar, the sample mean. So X bar is given as 24.8 minus mu. Mu, the population mean, is 25.6. Divided by S, the sample standard deviation is 3.5, over the square root of n. N is the size of the sample, so if we read through this problem, it says a sample of 25 New Bedford students. So the sample size is 25. Don't forget the square root. That makes a difference. That's sort of a common mistake. So now what I can do is start to simplify the computation down. In the numerator, I can do that right now. 24.8 minus 25.6 is negative 0.8. So don't just put 0.8. In this case, you would wind up with the right answer either way, coincidentally. But in general, you want to pay attention to positive or negative. And then 3.5 over, I can do the square root of 25. That comes out to a nice whole number. Is 5, because 5 times 5 is 25. And then I can simplify the denominator a little bit further. equals negative 0.8 over 3.5 divided by 5. I can do that without a calculator. I can see that it's 0.7. If you don't see it easily or you think it's 0.7 but you're not positive, just take a calculator, 3.5 divided by 5 equals, and you'll see, sure enough, it is 0.7. And now what we're going to do is negative 0.8 divided by 0.7. Now that doesn't work out as easily. I can see it's a little bit past 1, but beyond that, I'd want to use my calculator. So when I enter it into the calculator says it is negative 1.14287143. That's my calculated value for t, negative 1.14 with some more digits after that. Now the fifth step is determine the critical value for t. So this is a two-tailed test, and our level of significance, it says 10%. So for two-tail, for a total of 10% critical region, you're going to have half on the left end and half on the right end. So 5% for the left, 5% for the right. There's your total of 10% for a two-tail. If it's just the left or right, that full 10% would be either on the left or right side, but two-tail, you split it. So now, what value of t would put you at that either 0.05? So you go to the t-chart, student's t-chart, which is at the end of the homework assignment, and you want to look in the 0.05 column. And the row you want depends on the size of the sample. You want to do the row one less than the size of the sample. So if the size of the sample is 25, you want the row with 24. That's called degrees of freedom. It's labeled DF for degrees of freedom. So you get into the row with 24 degrees of freedom. See where it intersects the column labeled 0.05, and you'll see that it intersects at 1.78. Now that 1.78 you get is the positive in the right end, and the t thing, which is like the z, the standard normal, is symmetric, so the left end would be negative 1.78, same number but negative. Now the question is, our result of negative 1.14 is too close to the middle to really go into the either critical side. So since we have not gone out into the critical region, our conclusion, step six, state your conclusion, our conclusion would be fail to reject the null. So, fail to reject null. And they want you to word it that way. So it's not that you want to say accept the null, you fail to reject it. And that has to do with your maintaining your 10% level of significance. So what that's saying is most likely the students at the New Bedford campus have the same average age as the overall student population of BCC. This one particular sample had a slightly less of an average age, but that's not really due to there being a difference from one campus to the other. That was sort of coincidental. There's not enough evidence to conclude that there's a significant age difference, either younger or older, at the New Bedford campus.